development of this small scale industry. See, small scale industry development was also a policy which was introduced by the government. Why this policy was introduced by the government? See, in the large scale industry was more focusing on the was more capital intensive industry. More machineries were used in the large scale industries, right? And it requires more investment to establish a large scale industry. So smalls and the large scale industry development, the main focus was the infrastructure growth and the economic growth and development of the country. Whereas this development of this small scale industry had two objectives, that is employment and the equity. Which means less equity was required for the small scale industry and the equality, which is three E's. Equality. Equality means if you are starting up or establishing a small scale industry, which means you are providing the employment to the people living in the backward regions or the people who do not have money. So the small scale industries will give the income to the poor people, so which will help in distributing the income and which will help in creating the regional equality. So with this view, the small scale industries were set up. Recently, the definition of the small scale industry is defined as one whose investment does not exceed ₹5 crore. This is the definition now. But when this resolution was came in 1951, where the industrial resolution came, we were focusing on more on the industrial growth. At that time, the small scale industry was defined as one whose investment does not increase ₹5 lakh. Only ₹5 lakh were required to establish a small scale industry. Now, what were the typical characteristics of the small scale industries? The characteristics of small scale industry, number one is, small scale industry is a labor intensive and therefore employment friendly. Which means the large scale industries are capital intensive, which means they use large machineries to carry out the production, whereas the small scale industries are labor intensive, which means they employ more labor to carry out the production. So this gives employment to the poor section of the society. So this helps in the generation of employment in the economy. So SSI is a labor intensive industries. Second is your SSI shows locational flexibility. And is therefore equality oriented. See, many plants like Bhilai steel plant and Rourkela steel plants, these are actually situated at the places which are near to their raw material. So because the transportation charges are very high, if you want to transfer your raw material from one place to another. So these industries have set up themselves at the places near to their raw material, where they can get their raw material very easily. But if I talk about the small scale industry, these are actually established in the rural areas or the backward regions of the society, because their investment is very low, and the raw material which they require can be easily they can easily get from the backward section of society. So it actually provides the regional equality. All the regions are being equally developed, and there is equal growth just because of the small scale industries have come up. The third characteristic is SSI need small investment and is therefore equity oriented. See, I've told you about three E's of the small scale industry, that is employment, then equality, and then equity. Now, in order to establish a small scale industry, you need very small investment. So it is equity oriented. You do not require equity from the various sections of society. And if you establish a small scale industry, the government also gives you the industrial soap status, the power supplier, the concessional rates, tax-free rates. So it helps in the greater employment opportunities. So less equity is required, small investment is required. This is the other characteristics of the small-scale industry. So I hope you have completely understood this. Do download our Scholars Learning app and enjoy the learning experience with us.